أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وما خلقت الجن thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for all the bounties that He has given us. And we thank Allah for giving us the greatest gift, and that is hadiyatul iman, the gift of iman. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for allowing us to fulfill this obligation of Jumu'ah, and for allowing us to be amongst the early birds to enter the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and derive maximum benefit from this blessed day of Yawmul Jumu'ah. For wallahi, there is no better day during the week than the blessed day of Jumu'ah. It is a day of maghfirah, a day of forgiveness. It is a day of dua, of supplication. It is a day where we come to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to inspire our hearts to become better Muslims. My dear brothers and elders, mothers and sisters, it is so important as the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we constantly remind ourselves of the purpose of our existence. That why Allah azza wa jal has created me and you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not created anything in vain. As Allah azza wa jal says, أَفَحَسِبَتُمْ أَنَّمَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ عَبَثًا وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Allah says, do you think that we have created this creation or me and you in vain? Have we come into existence just like that for no reason? وَأَنَّكُمْ إِلَيْنَا لَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And do you think that we are not going to return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Wallahi, my dear brothers and sisters, we need to constantly remind ourselves, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. That Allah azza wa jal has created us, man and jinn, for one purpose. And that is to worship Allah. That is why we are here. That is why we have been created. We have not been created to work for this world and die in debt. We have not been created to work for 15, 16 hours a day. And we forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have not been created for that purpose. We have been created to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to recognize that Allah, huwa khaliqu kulli shay, Allah is powerful over everything. We have been created to recognize that badi'u samawati wal ard, that Allah is the originator of the heavens and the earth. We have been created to recognize that la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, that there is no ability and there is no power except with Allah. We have been created to recognize that there is none worthy of worship except Allah. We have been created, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. I say, O Muhammad, my living, my ibadah, my salah, my living and dying, my work, my sleep, my eating, every aspect of my life, لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. It is for Allah. It is for Allah جَلَّ جَلَالُهُ. It is for Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. It is important that we don't allow this world to be our ultimate objective. If we make this world our ultimate objective, we have failed in our understanding of the purpose of our existence. I will repeat this statement. If we make this world our ultimate objective, then we have failed in the understanding of the purpose of why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created me and you. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah has created this world for us, but we have been created for the hereafter. Everything that we do in this world is in preparation for our meeting with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى في سورة القصص وابتغ فيما آتاك الله وابتغ فيما آتاك الله الدار الآخرة. Allah says, and seek with that which we provided you in this world the hereafter. My dear brothers and sisters, we have defined success with the wrong meaning. In today's time, we classify a successful person, a person who is rich. We classify a successful person, someone who has money. Was Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam rich? No. But he had the choice. If he wanted Mount Uhud in gold, he could have that. The Prophet of Allah, if he wished, he could have all the wealth of this dunya. But the Prophet of Allah, he chose the simple life. In today's time, we categorize success in paying off your mortgage. We say, MashaAllah, Mabrook, well done, you've done so well. MashaAllah, he's successful. Let's just say a person living his life as a Muslim for 20 years, he pays off his house. But in that 20 years of being a Muslim, he never made one salah. But he paid off his mortgage. Is he successful? For 20 years of your life, you don't fast, you don't give zakat, you have no relationship with the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Is that success? It's not success. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Mu'minun, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. The mu'minun, they are the successful ones. الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ عَنِ اللَّغْوِ مُعْرِضُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِلزَّكَاةِ فَاعِلُونَ وَالَّذِينَ هُمْ لِفُرُوجِهِمْ حَافِظُونَ إلا على أزواجهم أو ما ملكت أيمانهم فإنهم غير ملومين فمن ابتغى وراء ذلك فأولئك هم العادون والذين هم لأماناتهم وعهدهم راعون والذين هم على صلواتهم يحافظون أولئك هم الوارثون. الله سبحانه وتعالى says, those who perform salah with khushu, those who protect their private parts, those who give zakat, those who fulfill the concept of trust, they are the inheritors. They are the successful ones. أُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْوَارِثُونَ They will be the inheritors. What will they inherit? الَّذِينَ يَرِثُونَ الْفِرْدَوْسَ هُمْ فِيهَا خَالِدُونَ They will inherit جَنَّةُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ That is a successful person. This world, we work so hard for something that is temporary. But yet we forget, وَالْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى That the hereafter, it is far much better than this world, and it is everlasting. Yes, we need to live our life. We need to live, we need to work, we need to do everything. But the ultimate objective is Allah. And this is where we have gone wrong. This is where we need to reconnect, to understand the purpose of why Allah has created me and you. That is success. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازَ Allahu Akbar. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, the one who is saved from the fire of Jahannam and he enters Jannah, you are a successful person. That is success. A person who can proudly say, Alhamdulillah, I have been a Muslim from such and such a time, and I can say, Alhamdulillah, I have never missed a salah in my life. MashaAllah, congratulations. For the past 20 years, I can say, MashaAllah, I have never missed one fast. Congratulations, MashaAllah. I have been a Muslim for so many years and Alhamdulillah, in the past 20 years, I can tap my shoulder and say, Alhamdulillah, I have fulfilled the rights of zakat. MashaAllah, you are successful. That is true success. Not boasting to people about what you have, about your material. That means nothing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not care what you have. إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَعَالَى لَا يَنْظُرُ إِلَى صُوَرِكُمْ وَأَمْوَالِكُمْ Verily Allah does not look at your bank balance. He doesn't look at where you come from. He doesn't look at what language you speak. وَلَكِي يَنْظُرُ إِلَى قُلُوبِكُمْ وَأَعْمَالِكُمْ But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He looks at our heart and He looks at our actions. Why is our heart important? Because the heart is the filter of all our deeds. If the heart is pure, إِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَتْ جَسَدُ كُلُّ If the heart is sahih, it is sound, it is healthy, then the entire body will be healthy. If your heart is clean, that means your iman is strong. If your heart is clean, then your iman is strong. My dear brothers and sisters, our ultimate objective is not only to work for this world, but it is to work for our Jannah. Because we want Jannah. We want Jannah. And Jannah is not easy. Like you want to buy that fancy car. You want to buy that Mercedes Benz. You want to buy that house. It requires effort. It requires lots of energy. Likewise, Jannah is not cheap. We take it for granted that, oh, I'm going to Jannah. No, my brothers. Jannah requires time. Jannah requires effort. But inshallah, with iman, we have the first key. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ كَانَتْ لَهُمْ جَنَّةُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ نُزُلًا Allah says, the one who has iman and he does righteous deeds, Allah will grant that person Jannatul Firdaus. Every day, I ask a question to my dear audience. How many of you make dua for Jannah? Be honest with yourself. How many of you, because we are the slaves of Allah and we need Allah. How many of us, we make dua after every salah? Allahumma inna nas'aluka al-Jannatul Firdaus. We ask you for Jannatul Firdaus because at the end of the day, we're getting old. We look in the mirror, we see grey hairs. And you know what? That grey hairs should remind us that my time is coming to an end. That grey hair should teach me and you. Oh, Imam, you've got a few grey hairs. One brother told me, Imam, you're getting old. I said, I'm still young. Yeah. He says, you're growing some grey hairs. I said, this is a sign for me that my qabr is around the corner. When you look at your beautiful face in the mirror and you see that beautiful white hair, don't dye it. Don't dye it. Utilize it as a warner that my time is coming to an end. Don't get too attached to this world. But what is the good news? The good news is we have another day to repent to Allah. We have another day to change our intention. Let us renew our intention. Ya Allah, I have been created. Yes, maybe for the past 50 years I have not done the right thing, but from today I'm going to change my life. My dear brothers and elders, إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازًا. The people of taqwa, they are successful. Around the corner, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in 3 weeks' time, is going to bless us with a golden opportunity. A very blessed opportunity, and that is شهر رمضان, the month of Ramadan. And that is why the Prophet of Allah, he made dua, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, allow us to reach the blessed month of Ramadan. And inshallah, this is the golden opportunity. This is the golden opportunity to reconnect to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the golden opportunity to remove those unnecessary barriers that exist between us and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the golden opportunity to build our paradise, insha'Allah. This is the golden opportunity for us to reinstate the true purpose of our existence, and that is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to make Allah and His Rasul the most beloved thing in this heart. Wallahi, my dear brothers, the Ramadan will come, insha'Allah, in 3 weeks. But we don't know whether we will live to see it. This is in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But inshallah, I'm hoping that each and every one of us, we are amongst those people, tabaraka wa ta'ala, that will reach this blessed month. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those people who will derive maximum benefit from this blessed month of Ramadan. I have jotted down 8 points, and this is the crux of my khutbah. And inshallah, these are 7 points, ways of how me and you, we can prepare for this blessed month of Ramadan. Because the month of Ramadan comes so quickly. And before we know it, it is Laylatul Qadr, it is Khatam al-Quran night, and we say, Ya Allah, what have I done? I have done nothing. So inshallah, this is not going to be the case this year. Say Ameen inshallah. This is not going to be the case this year. This year, I want to be one step ahead of this blessed month of Ramadan. So number one, make a strong intention from today, from right now, to make this month of Ramadan your best Ramadan. Say Ameen inshallah. Amen. I want you all to make this niyyah that yani from today, make your intention. I want this Ramadan, this fasting month, to be the best Ramadan that I will ever experience. Make that intention, because إِنَّمَا الْأَعْمَالُ بِالنِّيَّةِ. Every action will be judged according to our intention. So make a firm intention that, Ya Allah, this Ramadan coming, I'm going to exert myself. And inshallah, I want to leave this month of Ramadan the best Muslim on this earth, inshallah ta'ala. This is the first thing. Number two, have a Ramadan countdown. Prepare yourself mentally. The month of Ramadan is about to come. Be excited, look forward to it. A lot of people say, oh no, Ramadan is coming. Oh, that's a sign of weak iman. Oh no, I have to fast. Yani, I miss my qahwa in the morning. You know, the Lebanese qahwa. MashaAllah, beautiful. You know, up for the whole day and all night. Right? Oh, I can't. No. Subhanallah, prepare yourself. Allahu Akbar, Alhamdulillah. The month of Ramadan, another chance. Allah has given me another chance. So prepare yourself mentally. Look forward to it. And when it comes, embrace it. Embrace it, inshallah ta'ala. Point number three, many of our ummah have passed away and they are unable to experience 2018 Ramadan. Make dua to Allah every day that Ya Allah, Allahumma balighna Ramadan. Because wallahi, we can die now. We can die tomorrow. We can die next week. So make dua to Allah that Allah grants us the honor and privilege to experience many more months of Ramadan. Allahumma ameen. Point number four, for those people who have missed their fast Ensure that you make up your fast before the month of Ramadan comes in, especially for the sisters. Also, in preparation for Ramadan, try your best to fast Monday and Thursday so that you get into the blend of fasting before the coming of the blessed month of Ramadan. Point number five, prepare a practical Ramadan plan for this coming Ramadan. It is very important, an action plan. What am I going to do every single day during the blessed month of Ramadan? We all need to, inshallah, plan an action plan. Plan your entire day. Okay, I'm going to get up before the suhoor. I'm going to make sure, a lot of people, what they do, unfortunately, they say, mashallah, the month of Ramadan, Habibi, I'm up the whole night. But you're up whole night smoking shisha, my friend. You're up the whole night smoking. This is not ibadah. Eating ka'ak, smoking shisha, I'm up the whole night, Sheikh. And then you sleep right till asr the next day. And you wake up in the morning, alhamdulillah. You wake up in the morning saying, alhamdulillah. You miss your fajr, you miss your dhuhr, you miss your asr prayer. Is this Islam? Is this how we fast? My dear brothers, fast correctly. The month of Ramadan is not to stay up at night and make ghibah of people. You don't stay up the whole night eating kak and smoking shisha and making ghibah of people. This is not how you fast. Make an action plan. I'm going to get up in the morning. I'm going to make some tahajjud prayer. I'm going to eat the morning breakfast, even if it's a little bit. Don't eat too much. Eat a little bit, because Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, فَإِنَّ فِي الصُّحُورِ بَرَكَةٌ. The suhoor in the morning, there is barakah, there is blessing. So for the sake of sunnah, have a very little meal. Make sure, tell yourself, inshallah, during the blessed month of Ramadan, I'm going to try my best to make most of my prayers in the masjid. Tell yourself, inshallah, I want to stand every single night. I want to come for Salatul Taraweeh. I'm going to choose a masjid and I'm going to stand behind the imam for 20 raka'ats. I'm going to come every single day. Make this niyyah in your mind. Tell yourself, if I'm able to take off work for the last 10 days of this blessed month, come and join Imam Akram at Slack Street Masjid. For the last 10 days of Ramadan, come and join me at this masjid. Spend the last 10 days of your Ramadan. Guaranteed you will receive the reward of Laylatul Qadr. Make your intention from today. Please, if you stay up at night, make ibadah and stay away from the shisha. Please, right? Also, plan your sadaqah, plan your charity, feed the poor, feed the orphans. Prepare from today, subhanAllah. What am I going to do? How am I going to plan to make this Ramadan 2018 the best month, inshallah ta'ala? Point number six, work out a healthy diet plan for the month of Ramadan. Unfortunately, in the month of Ramadan, we are supposed to lose weight. But unfortunately, we gain weight, right? The month of Ramadan is not a month of feasting. It is a month of fasting. Whole day we are planning, talking to the wife. You know, what are we going to, what, you're making samosa today? You're making kanafa? You're making mansaf? You're making tabbouleh? We're making all of it. Whole day you're talking about food. Leave the food. Don't worry about the food. Food is not important. Focus on ibadah. Focus on dhikr. Focus on Quran. Focus on changing yourself to become a better Muslim. So utilize this month of Ramadan not to feast. Unfortunately, subhanAllah, when we come to the iftar table, it is so full. And then we have burping competition in Taraweeh prayer. Who can burp the loudest and the longest? Don't come to Salatul Taraweeh and start blowing your burps left, right, center, up and above. No. Eat just enough to quench your hunger and then come for Salah. Apply perfume and come in a respectful manner. If you overeat, subhanAllah, then what have you achieved? What have you achieved? Keep it simple this Ramadan. Speak to your wife. Don't demand her to cook, cook, cook. Keep it simple. And rather tell your woman folk to focus on ibadah, worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is very sad that our woman folk are always deprived during the month of Ramadan. They are always deprived. Why? Because they're busy cooking in the kitchen. So let us change that inshallah ta'ala. My dear respected brothers, the last point, increase your knowledge about the rules and regulations pertaining to the month of Ramadan. What breaks the fast? What's permissible? What's not permissible? Increase your knowledge of the ahadith. And of course, during the Jumu'ah khutbah, we will talk about some of these fada'il inshaAllah ta'ala. But very importantly, when you enter the month of Ramadan, clean your heart. Don't enter the month of Ramadan with a hard heart. Forgive everyone. Enter this month of Ramadan, forgive everyone. If you have a quarrel in your heart, or you have some tension between brothers, between parents, between family members, wallahi min al-yawm, from now on, forgive them for the sake of Allah. Enter the month of Ramadan with a clean heart. And inshallah, you will leave with all of your sins forgiven, inshallah. Man sama Ramadan, imanan wa ihtisaban, ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanb. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the person who fasts during the month of Ramadan with iman, hoping for his sins to be forgiven, Allah will forgive all of your sins. May Allah, Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Allahumma ballighna Ramadan. Oh Allah, allow us to reach the blessed month of Ramadan. Ya Allah, allow us to experience many more blessed months of Ramadan. And Ya Allah, we ask you on this blessed day of Jumu'ah to make us of those people that derive maximum benefit from this golden opportunity. May we be amongst those people that graduate through the school of taqwa. Allahumma.